请大家抓紧拍照。
坐吧，好吧，就坐，请坐。好，谢谢，
请大家回到原座。
Please return to your seats.
各位记者朋友，大家上午好，欢迎参加十三届全国人大议事会议记者会。本场记者会的主题是中国的外交政策和对外关系。今天我们很高兴地邀请到外交部部长王毅先生来回答与这一主题相关的问题。有请王部长。
Dear members of the press, good morning. Welcome to the press conference of the first session of the 13th National People's Congress. The theme of this press conference is on China's foreign policy and external relations. We are delighted to have invited Foreign Minister Wang Yi to take your related questions.
各位记者朋友，大家上午好。首先，我还是要向在座的女记者们，还有所有的。 女同胞们，致以今日的祝福。同时，我也要借此机会啊，向所有关心和支持中国外交的中外记者们表示我们的感谢，因为中国外交取得的成绩当中，有大家付出的一份辛劳和贡献，大家辛苦了。现在，我愿意回答大家的问题。Dear
members of the press, good morning. At the outset, I wish to extend festive greetings to all Chinese women. Including the female journalists in this room. I also wish to thank the press, Chinese and foreign, for having shown understanding and support for China's foreign policy and external relations. Everything we have accomplished, you have played a part. Thank you. Now I'm ready to take your questions.
谢谢，开始提问。右区第五排那位男士，第五排。
谢谢主持人，外长您好，我是人民日报的记者。党的十八大以来，外交工作取得了前所未有的重要成就，也赢得了全国人民的一致点赞。那我们也知道呢，2018年是十九大之后的开局之年，所以今年中国外交有哪些亮点，能否请您为我们介绍一下？谢谢。People's
Daily, since the 18th National Congress of the Communist Party of China, China has made unprecedented progress in its foreign relations. Which is widely praised across the country. Following the 19th Party Congress, what will be the highlights of China's diplomatic agenda this year?
党的十八大以来，在以习近平同志为核心的党中央的政权领导之下，我们确实走出了一条具有中国特色、中国气派、中国风格的大国外交之路。 我们为维护国家主权和人民利益，为服务国内改革开放大局发挥的重要作用，取得了历史性的成就。去年十月份，习近平主席、习近平总书记在中共十九大报告当中强调，我们要同各国一道共同建设新型国际关系，共同构建人民命运共同体，这就是新时代。
Under the outstanding leadership of the CPC Central Committee, with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core since the 18th Party Congress 5 years ago, we have traveled on a road of major country diplomacy that reflects China's distinct vision, style, and values. Producing historic accomplishments, our diplomatic efforts have been instrumental to upholding China's interests and dignity. And to facilitating China's reform and development. Last October, General Secretary Xi Jinping emphasized in his report to the 19th Party Congress that China will work with other countries to foster a new type of international relations and to build a global community with a shared future. This is the aim of China's major country diplomacy in the new era.
2018年是贯彻落实十大精神的开局之年。中国外交将在习近平新时代中国特色社会思想指引下，拿出新作为，展现新气象。今年的中国外交亮点主要体现在四大主场活动上。一是四月在海南举行博鳌亚洲论坛的年会，主旋律是改革开放。今年恰逢中国改革开放40周年，本届年会将总结改革开放成功经验，展示新时代深化改革扩大开放的新前景。26月在青岛举行上海合作组织峰会，主旋律是弘扬上海精神。扩员后的上合组织将重温互信互利、平等协商、尊重多样文明、谋求共同发展的上海精神，开启上合组织发展壮大的新征程。39月在北京举行中非合作论坛峰会，主旋律是一带一路。非洲各国的兄弟姐妹将会以这次峰会为契机，全方位的参与一带一路的建设，为中非全面战略伙伴关系注入新动力。12月在上海首次举行中国国际进口博览会，主旋律是市场开放，中国将向世界张开双臂，展现市场潜力，欢迎各国参与和分享中国发展的机遇。总之，2018年中国外交的大幕已经拉开，新时代的中国外交将为中国自身发展营造更好的外部环境，也为人类进步事业提供更多的正能量。谢谢你。
2018 is the first year for implementing the decisions of the 19th Party Congress, guided by Xi Jinping's thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for a new era. We in the diplomatic service will take new steps and make new advances. The main highlights of China's diplomatic calendar will include the following 4 events we're going to host. First, the Bao Forum for Asia annual conference, which will take place in Hainan this April, and focus on reform and opening up. In this 40th anniversary year of reform and opening up, we will review China's successful experience and sketch new possibilities for reform and opening up in the new era. Second, the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Summit, which will take place in Qingdao this June, and focus on revitalizing the Shanghai spirit. The expanded SCO will rededicate itself to the Shanghai spirit of mutual trust and benefit, equal-footed consultation, respect for diversity of civilizations, and pursuit of common development. The summit will set the SCO on the new journey of consolidation and growth. Third, the Forum on China-Africa Cooperation Summit, which will take place in Beijing this September, and focus on the Belt and Road Initiative. A great opportunity for our African brothers and sisters to participate fully in the BRI, the summit will give new impetus to the China-Africa Comprehensive Strategic Partnership. Fourth, the first China International Import Expo, which will take place in Shanghai this December, and focus on the further market opening. China will embrace the world with open arms and enormous market potential. All will be welcome to access and benefit from the new opportunities of China's development. China's diplomatic agenda for 2018 are unfolding even as we speak. In the new era, we will work harder to see that China will enjoy a better environment for development and make greater contributions to human progress. Thank you.
下一个问题，白冰，中区第二排第四位这位先生，穿绿衣服。
Thank you, Foreign Minister. I'm from Reuters. I have a North Korea-related question for you. China has always said that one of the most important issues in the North Korea crisis is for there to be direct talks between North Korea and the United States. So what role does China have to facilitate such talks? And does China also believe that the United States needs to withdraw its military forces in South Korea for there to be a lasting peace on the Korean Peninsula? Thank you.
路透社, 中国一直高度重视朝美的直接谈判, 请问中国在这方面可以发挥什么作用? 为了实现半岛长治久安, 中方是否认为美方应该撤离驻韩美军?
这是一个当前国际社会最关注的一个话题。 我们看到, 朝韩双方抓住冬奥会的契机, 开展了一系列的密集的互动, 南北关系迅速解冻, 这位冰封已久的半岛局势, 注入了一股暖流, 也是一股久违的暖流。 发生这样的变化, 有人似乎感到困惑, 但其实是情理当中。 我们看到冬奥会期间, 朝鲜并没有进行新的核导试验, 美国、韩国也暂停了针对朝鲜的军演。 事实证明啊, 中方提出的双暂停的倡议, 是一剂对症下药的良方, 为南北改善关系营造了最基本的条件。
This is the hottest topic in the world today. Seizing the opportunity of the Pyeongchang Olympics, the DPRK and the ROK have had a succession of interactions and achieved a rapid thaw in their relations, reversing the long-standing chill on the Korean Peninsula. The recent developments may seem baffling to some people, but are actually within the bounds of reason. During the Winter Games, the DPRK did not conduct any nuclear test, and the US and the ROK suspended their joint exercises targeting the DPRK. This proves that China's proposal of suspension for suspension was the right prescription for the problem and created basic conditions for the improvement of inter-Korean relations.
The
Korean Peninsula issue has finally taken an important step in the right direction. China fully commends and supports the efforts made by the two Koreas. To return the peninsula to peace and the nuclear issue to the track of dialogue, these initial steps must be followed up by corresponding and concerted efforts by the parties. To this end, we call on the parties, particularly the US and the DPRK, to engage in dialogue sooner rather than later. We encourage the parties to follow a dual-track approach of remaining committed to the goal of denuclearization and working actively to establish a peace mechanism on the peninsula. By addressing the parties' legitimate security concerns, including those of the DPRK, in exchange for and in tandem with progress towards denuclearization. And this is China's long-standing position and also the vision set forth in the relevant Security Council resolutions.
我还要说的是啊,冰冻三尺非一日之寒,尽管隧道的尽头已经显露曙光, 但是前行的道路不可能一帆风顺。历史经验告诉我们啊，每当半岛出现缓和时，各种干扰就会如影随形，接踵而至。现在又到了检验各方是不是真心希望解决半岛核问题的关键时刻。和平必须争取，机遇需要把握。各方应以半岛和平大局为重，以本地区人民安危为重，拿出政治勇气，做出政治决断，尽快开展一切必要和有益的双多边接触，全力推动重启和平解决半岛核问题的对话谈判。中方我们将为此继续做出我们的努力，谢谢。
Of course, it takes more than one cold day to freeze 3 feet of ice. Despite light at the end of the tunnel, the journey ahead won't be smooth. History has reminded us time and again that whenever tension subsided on the peninsula, the situation would be clouded by various interferences. Now is a crucial moment for testing the sincerity of the parties. Peace must be fought for. Opportunity needs to be seized.It falls to all parties to bear in mind the imperative of peace and the well-being of people in the region. All must demonstrate political courage and make a political decision to expeditiously carry out all necessary and useful engagements, both bilateral and plurilateral, and to do their best to restart dialogue and negotiation for the peaceful settlement of the nuclear issue. China will continue to make unremitting efforts.For this outcome. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。左边第四排这位女士。
谢谢主持人，我是中央电视台央视网央视新闻移动网的记者。我想请问外长的是，这些年中国的民众啊，普遍有一个深切的体会，就是自从十八大以来，习近平主席啊亲力亲为开展元首外交，引领树立起了新时代的大国形象，展现出了领袖风范，同时呢也推动中国国际地位和影响得到了历史性的提升。所以想在这里请教外长，您是怎么看待中国元首外交的重要作用和影响的？谢谢。
China Central Television. The Chinese people can tell that in the last 5 years,President Xi has been fully engaged in China's foreign policy. His personal diplomacy has enhanced China's image as a major country entering a new era, presented his image as a global statesman, and raised China's standing and international influence like never before. How do you see the role and impact of diplomacy conducted by President Xi as head of state?
元首外交是国际交往的最高形态，有着其他交往无法替代的重要作用和战略价值。党的十八大以来啊，习近平主席作为中国特色大国外交的总设计师，亲自擘画和推进了精彩纷呈的元首外交。习主席遍访世界57个国家，接待了110多位外国元首访华，这些重大的外交行动不仅极大增进了国际社会对中国的了解，有效提升了中国的国际地位和影响，也为解决当今许多全球性问题指明了方向。而习主席本人的领袖风范和人格魅力，也使很多不同社会制度、不同文化背景的领导人都成为了他的好朋友，也成为了中国的好朋友。
Head of state diplomacy, as the highest form of state-to-state interaction, plays a pivotal role and has irreplaceable strategic value. Since 2012, President Xi Jinping has been the chief architect of China's major country diplomacy. He was personally involved in the planning and the conduct of head of state diplomacy, which by all accounts has been brilliant.To date, President Xi has visited 57 countries in different parts of the world and received more than 110 foreign heads of state. These important visits and meetings go a long way towards deepening the world's understanding of China, enhancing China's profile and influence, and facilitating the solution of many global problems. President Xi's leadership and charisma have earned him and his country many good friends among foreign leaders who represent a diverse range of cultures and social systems.
2018年除了主持刚才所说的四大主场活动之外，习主席还将赴南非、巴布亚新几内亚还有阿根廷去出席金砖国家领导人峰会、亚太经合组织领导人非正式会议以及20国集团领导人的会晤。我们相信习主席亲力亲为的元首外交将会进一步展现为人民谋福、为国家负责、为世界担当的博大情怀，书写新时代中国特色大国外交的崭新的篇章。谢谢。
In the year ahead, President Xi will host the 4 diplomatic events I mentioned earlier, and he will also participate in the BRICS Summit in South Africa, the APEC Economic Leaders Meeting in Papua New Guinea, and the G20 Summit in Argentina. We believe that President Xi's personal diplomacy will make a positive and responsible contribution to the welfare of his people, the interests of China, and the well-being of the world. It will write a whole new chapter of major country diplomacy with Chinese characteristics in the new era. Thank you.
好，谢谢。下一个问题。右区第三排，这边第一个，马云。
您好，我是彭博社的记者。美国总统特朗普说，他愿意采取一切工具来防止中国的国有经济模式破坏国际竞争。那么请问，中国是否也愿意采取一切工具来反击？如果是的话，中国将会采取哪一些工具呢？谢谢。
Bloomberg, U.S. President Donald Trump has said he will use all tools at his disposal to prevent China's state economic model from undermining international competition. How will China respond to that? Thank you.
你这个问题本身就很有攻击性，当然我认为你主要还是要问中美的关系。作为外长，我有责任首先就我们的对美政策要向记者朋友们再做一次明确的重申。中美双方达成的重要的共识啊，是很多的。我们都认为，中美在维护世界和平稳定繁荣方面拥有广泛共同利益和重要的责任。双方将在互利互惠基础上拓展各领域合作，在相互尊重基础上管控好分歧和矛盾。我们还要加强两国人民之间的相互了解与友谊，合作应对重大的地区和全球性挑战，从而推动中美关系能够持续健康和稳定的发展。
This is a quite sharp question. As the foreign minister, let me reiterate for you China's policy towards the China-US relationship. Our two countries are agreed that we share broad interests and important responsibilities for global peace, stability, and prosperity.Our two countries are to carry out broad-based cooperation on the basis of mutual benefit, manage our differences on the basis of mutual respect, deepen mutual understanding and friendship between our people, and work together to address major regional and global challenges. Our two countries must work for the sustained, healthy, and steady growth of our relations.
中美之间主要是合作。两国人民之间有着非常广泛和密切的交往。我在这之前看到了一个美国民调的最新数字，这个数字表明美国民众对中国的好感度超过了50%，这是近30年来最高的数字，而且近年来的不断的提高。我希望我们记者朋友们在看到问题的时候，也要看到这些积极的因素的生长。作为世界上最大的发展中国家和最大的发达国家，中美合作 将造福两国，也将惠及世界。如果说中美之间有竞争的话，那也应该是良性和积极的竞争，这在国际交往当中也是很正常的。换句话说，中美可以有竞争，不必做对手，更需当伙伴。
Cooperation is the main thrust of China-US relations, and there are broad-based and close interactions between the two countries. According to the latest poll, over 50% of the American people have a favorable view of China. The figure has been rising steadily in recent years, and the figure I've just cited is the highest one in nearly 30 years. So I hope people will not just focus on the problems in China-US relations, but will also pay attention to the positive aspects. As the world's largest developing and the largest developed country, the top two economies, and permanent members of the UN Security Council, China and America working together will benefit not just our own countries, but also the whole world. If there is any competition between us, it has to be healthy and positive. In fact, the competition aside, China and the United States don't have to be rivals, but we should strive to be partners in cooperation.
中国将继续坚持走自己选择的发展道路。中国的发展振兴已不可阻挡，这已成为国际社会的普遍的认知。美国一些人认为中国因此要取代美国在国际上的作用，这是一个根本性的战略误判，因为我们走的是中国特色社会主义道路，核心要义是坚持和平发展，成功之处在于合作共赢，这与传统大国曾经走过的路是完全不同的，而且正在得到越来越多的国家的认同和欢迎。也就是说，中国越发展，越能为世界做贡献。当然，中国实现自身现代化的道路还很长，我们不会也不必去取代美国的作用。中美双方应该在遵守中美三个联合公报和各方双方各项共识基础上，相互尊重，优势互补，互利共赢。中美关系数十年历经风雨，但是对话与合作始终是主线，因为这是唯一明智也是现实的选择。
China is determined to stay on the path it has chosen, and China's development and revitalization is unstoppable. This is the consensus of the international community. Some Americans see China as a strategic competitor and allege that China will replace America's role in the world. This strategic conclusion is fundamentally wrong. China is on the path of socialism with distinctive Chinese characteristics. China's success is underpinned by its commitment to peaceful development and win-win cooperation. China's path is completely different from that of traditional powers, and as such is commended and welcomed by a growing number of countries. The truth is, the more China develops, the more contribution China will be make to the world. China is on a long march to modernization. It has no need or intention to displace America. China and America must respect each other, combine our strengths, and pursue win-win cooperation on the basis of the three joint communiques and our common understandings. China-US relations have gone through a lot in the past few decades, but dialogue and cooperation has always carried the day. It is the wise thing to do. There can be no alternative.
大家都关心中美的贸易摩擦。我想告诉大家的是，历史的经验证明，打贸易战从来都不是解决问题的正确途径。尤其是在全球化的今天，选择贸易战更是抓错了药方，结果只会损人害己。 中方也必将做出正当和必要的反应。作为两个利益高度融合的大国，作为世界第一和第二大经济体，中美既要对两国人民负责，也要对世界各国负责。我们还是希望双方心平气和地坐下来，通过平等和建设性对话来共同找出一个互利双赢的解决办法。谢谢。
As for our trade frictions, history teaches that trade war is never the right solution. In a globalized world, it is particularly unhelpful, as it will harm the initiator as well as the target country. In the event of a trade war, China will make a justified and necessary response. The bottom line is, as the world's largest economies, China's and America's interests are deeply entwined. We must bear in mind not just the interests of our own people, but also the well-being of the world. When all is said and done, we hope China and America will have a calm and constructive dialogue as equals and find a win-win solution. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。中区靠后面的那位男士。
谢谢，我是中国日报 China Daily 的记者，有一个问题问王外长，就是在过去的一年中，我们看到中方就若开邦问题在缅甸和孟加拉国之间进行了斡旋，我们也看到去年在北京举行了巴以和平人士这个座谈会，也看到了去年中方首次成功的举办了中阿巴三方外长对话。那么现在就有评论猜测说，中国正在一改过去不干涉内政的原则，并且将更多的未来在更多的去干预别国或地区的事务。那么请问这是否正是中国外交的新趋势？谢谢。
China Daily. In the past year, China mediated in the Rakhine issue between Myanmar and Bangladesh, brought Palestinian and Israeli peace advocates to a seminar in Beijing, and hosted the inaugural China, Afghanistan, Pakistan Foreign Minister's Dialogue. These initiatives give rise to the view that China has abandoned its long-standing policy of non-interference in favor of a more interventionist approach. Are we seeing a new trend in China's foreign policy?
作为安理会的常任理事国，中国始终把维护国际安全作为自己应尽的责任。早在上世纪五十年代，我们就为和平解决印度支那问题做出过重要的贡献，而今天的中国，我们更应为解决地区和国际热点问题积极发挥作用，这既是我们应该做的，也是各方的普遍期待。
As a permanent member of the Security Council, China takes seriously its responsibility for maintaining international security. Even in the 1950s, we made an important contribution to the peaceful settlement of the Indo-China issue. Today, China is in a much better position to help resolve various regional and international issues. We are ready to play our part. Indeed, the world expects no less from us.
中国参与解决热点问题有着鲜明的中国特色，始终坚持有所为也有所不为。归纳起来有三条，就是和平性、正当性和建设性。和平性就是坚持政治解决方向，主张通过对话谈判来解决任何的矛盾分歧，坚决反对使用武力。正当性就是要坚持不干涉内政原则，尊重当事国的主权和意愿，坚决反对强加于人。建设性就是坚持客观公正立场，根据事情本身的是非曲直来斡旋调停，坚决反对谋取私利。这三个特色来源于中国优秀的文化传统，植根于中国外交的成功实践，也符合联合国宪章的宗旨和原则，同时也为解决当今世界各种冲突和挑战提供了正确的导向和积极的借鉴。谢谢。
In helping to settle various flashpoints, we follow a distinctly Chinese approach. There are things we will do, and there are things we won't do. Put simply, our approach is at once peaceful, justifiable, and constructive. Let me explain them in turn. First, we prefer a political settlement of disputes through dialogue and negotiation, and firmly reject the use of force. Second, we respect other countries' wish and sovereignty and never meddle in their internal affairs. Indeed, we firmly reject imposing one's own views on others. Third, we do our best to be fair and objective and proceed from the merits of the matter. At the same time, we firmly reject pursuing private ends. Our approach is rooted in traditional Chinese culture and our successful diplomatic practice. In keeping with the purposes and principles of the UN Charter, it shows the right way and provides a good example for resolving various conflicts and challenges in the world. Thank you.
好，谢谢。下一问题。中区第五排第四位的先生。
谢谢主持人，晚上好。今日俄罗斯国际通讯社，俄罗斯大选将于3月18日举行，您对此有什么预期？在此背景下，我还想提一个关于中俄关系的问题。近年来，各方对俄罗斯及其国际地位看法不一。俄罗斯受到严厉评论、批评和经济制裁，与此同时，中国已成为世界第二大经济体，各方认为它将会将在国际政治中取代美国的领导地位。请问现在中国如何看待俄罗斯？您对将中俄关系的发展有何期待？谢谢。
Real novosti. Russia's presidential election is scheduled for March the 18th. What do you think the result is going to be? In recent years, opinion on Russia and its international role has been divided.My country has been subject to fierce criticism and economic sanctions. China, in the meantime, has become the world's second largest economy and is projected to take over US leadership in international politics. How does China view Russia and the prospects of our relationship?
谢谢。
俄罗斯总统选举啊，这是俄罗斯国家和人民的大事。我们看到，在普京总统的领导之下，近年来俄罗斯的国家发展取得了重要的成就。普京总统始终得到了俄罗斯人民的坚定支持，所以我们相信俄罗斯人民一定会再次做出正确的选择。俄罗斯民族也一定会在国家振兴道路上继续阔步前行。俄罗斯是一个有韧性、有坚持、也能抗压的民族。我们祝福俄罗斯，也祝福俄罗斯人民。
The presidential election is of vital importance to Russia and its people. We note that President Putin has overseen important strides in Russia's development and commanded strong support from his people.We trust the Russian people will again make the right choice and advance steadily towards national revitalization. The Russian people are a resilient, committed one, able to stand pressure. Our best wishes for Russia and the Russian people.
至于中俄关系，我们对中俄关系的前景始终充满信心。我们的信心啊来自于两个元首结下的深厚的友谊和互信，这将是继续引领两国关系发展的根本的保障。我们的信心还来源于双方各种务实合作的不断的深化，来源于在彼此核心利益上坚定的相互支持，也来源于在国际事务当中的 密切的协作，两国各界日益频繁的交流和往来。总之，中俄全面战略协作伙伴关系稳如泰山。请你向俄罗斯的朋友们转达一句话：中俄深化合作没有止境，中俄关系没有最好，只有更好。谢谢。
China has great confidence in its relationship with Russia. Our confidence comes from the strong trust and friendship between our presidents, which is fundamental to the further growth of our relationship. It also comes from the deepening of our cooperation in so many fields, our firm support for each other's core interests, our close coordination on international affairs, and the growing exchanges between our two societies. In short,The China-Russia Comprehensive Strategic Partnership of Coordination is as unshakable as a mountain. I ask you to convey this to our friends in Russia. The sky is the limit for Sino-Russian cooperation, and there is always room to make the relationship even better than it already is. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。右区第三排这位女士，第三排。
谢谢主持人，外长好，我是环球时报环球网的记者。近年来呢，中国在各个领域的影响力都在不断的上升，尤其是十九大之后呢，国人对于未来更是充满了期待。但是呢，我们也同时注意到，在国际上呢，也开始了新一轮中国威胁论的炒作，比如说认为中国正在用瑞士力来影响世界等等。那么我想请问您对此有何回应？谢谢。
Global Times.China's influence has been on the rise across the board. The 19th Party Congress gives Chinese people greater confidence in their country's future, but also ammunition to those in the world who try to paint China as a threat, who say that China will use its so-called sharp power to influence the world. How do you counter this claim?
过去几十年，西方一直在对中国做出各种评判和预测。归纳起来，无非一种是中国崩溃论，一种是中国威胁论。随着中国的持续发展，中国崩溃论自己先崩溃了，变成了一个国际笑柄。而中国威胁论虽然有了新的翻版，但却更加不得人心，因为事实胜于雄辩。事实是什么？那就是中国是全球经济增长的主要贡献者，年均贡献率达到了30%以上，超过了美国、日本以及欧元区国家的总和。中国是全球减贫事业的主要贡献者，贡献率超过了70%，创造了人类历史上的奇迹。中国还是维护世界和平的主要贡献者，我们成为联合国安理会五个常任理事国当中派出维和人员最多的国家，维和经费的出资已经占到了世界第二位。此外，在过去五年当中，中国还通过提出共建一带一路这些重大的倡议，成为了参与全球治理、维护贸易自由化以及开放性经济学论可以休矣。
For decades, the West has made all kinds of assessments and predictions about China. To some Westerners, China is either collapsing or threatening. As China continues to grow, the first theory has collapsed and become an international laughingstock. Meanwhile, proponents of the second theoryhave conjured up different versions, which find dwindling support. Let us not forget, facts speak louder than words. What are the facts? For years, China has been a leading contributor to global economic growth. At more than 30%, China's contribution is bigger than that of America, Japan, and the Eurozone combined. China accounts for more than 70% of poverty reduction worldwide.A miracle in human history. As the largest contributor of peacekeeping personnel among the permanent members of the Security Council and the second largest contributor to the UN peacekeeping budget, China is bearing a weighty responsibility for maintaining world peace. Not to mention that in the last 5 years, with its Belt and Road Initiative and other major proposals, China has come to the fore in championing global governance, free trade, and an open global economy. From these solid facts, those who do not have bias or practice double standards will see in China not a threat, but plenty of opportunities. So it's time the China threat theory was laid to rest. Thank you.
好，谢谢。下一个问题，左区第四排这位先生戴眼镜。啊，对对。
谢谢主持人，我是哈萨克斯坦国际通讯社的记者。我的问题，关于“一带一路”倡议。自习主席，宣布“一带一路”倡议以来，到2018年已过去5年。现在，包括哈萨克斯坦在内的许多国家都将“一带一路”倡议与自己的国家发展战略对接。但我们也感到。个别西方人也对倡议目的、实现方式、透明度以及是否符合国际规则有疑虑。请问未来5年的“一带一路”倡议会如何发展？如何回答该战略的质疑？谢谢。
Casting form。5 years ago, President Xi launched the Belt and Road Initiative. Many countries, including my own, have sought synergy between their national development strategies and the BRI. Some Westerners, however, seem to harbor doubts about the BRI's objective, approach, transparency, and its conformity with international rules. How will the BRI evolve in the next 5 years? How will China set out?To resolve the doubts about it.
一带一路是中国提出的阳光倡议，共商、共建、共享，是推进一带一路的黄金法则。这六个字啊，决定了一带一路的合作具有鲜明的平等性、开放性和普惠性。也就是说，无论是规划合作蓝图，还是实施具体项目，都是由参与方商量着办，一切都在阳光下运作，没有一家独大，而是各方平等参与，没有暗箱操作，而是坚持公开透明，没有赢者通吃，而是谋求互利共赢。
The Belt and Road is a transparent initiative launched by China. It follows the golden rule.Of extensive consultation, joint contribution, and shared benefits. Belt and Road cooperation aims to be equal-footed, inclusive, and universally beneficial. The planning and implementation of BRI projects have been discussed by the participants in the open. No country is dominating the process. All parties have an equal say. There is no backroom deal. Everything is transparent.There is no winner takes all. Every project delivers win-win results.
去年五月份，140多个国家代表出席了“一带一路”国际合作高峰论坛，这是国际社会对“一带一路”投出的信任票和支持票。迄今已有80多个国家和国际组织同中方签署了共建“一带一路”合作协议，一大批合作项目正在全面的推进。为当地的经济社会发展发挥了雪中送炭的作用。我举几个例子啊，比如中国在巴基斯坦开工建设的10几座电站，将彻底解决巴基斯坦国内缺电限电的历史困境。其中一座电站就满足了上千万民众的日常的需求。中国企业收购了陷入困境的塞尔维亚的钢厂，不到1年就扭亏为盈， 不仅保住了5000多人的就业，还使整个城市浴火重生。中国企业接手希腊最大的港口的经营，货物吞吐量迅速回升，重新跻身欧洲大港的行列。中国和法国联手在英国建设核电站，成为一带一路高新技术项目合作的典范。一带一路是全球公共产品，当然遵守国际规则。一带一路是国际合作平台，自然按照市场规律来行事。去年高峰论坛发表的联合公报已经对此做出了公开的承诺。公报还强调要统筹好经济、社会、金融和环境之间的关系，增强合作项目的可持续性。我们真诚的欢迎啊，各方为“一带一路”来建言献策，我们共同把“一带一路”建设好、推进好，不仅加强各国基础设施的硬联通，也要开展政策、规则和标准的软联通，不仅接地气，还要高标准，不仅效益好，而且高质量，不仅惠及中国，更要造福世界。谢谢。
Last May, the representatives of more than 140 countries participated in the first Belt and Road Forum for International Cooperation. The turnout is a clear vote of confidence from the international community. To date, more than 80 countries and international organizations have signed BRI agreements with China. A large number of BRI projects are well underway and adding needed momentum to the economic and social development of the host countries. Let me share a few examples with you. China is building over a dozen power stations for Pakistan, the largest of which is supplying electricity to tens of millions of Pakistanis. When all of them are completed, power cuts and shortages will be a thing of the past in Pakistan. In Serbia, a Chinese enterprise bought a troubled steel mill and turned it around in less than a year, both saving more than 5,000 local jobs and helping to re-energize the city in which the steel mill is located. In Greece, a Chinese group took over the operation of its largest seaport, ramped up the container volume, and put it back in the same league as Europe's largest ports. China is also partnering with France to build a nuclear power plant in Britain, a stellar example of high-tech cooperation under the BRI. As a global public good, the BRI, of course, follows international rules. As a platform for international cooperation, it naturally follows market principles. The joint communique of last year's forum committed to this and emphasized the importance of economic, social, fiscal, financial, and environmental sustainability of projects. We sincerely ask for ideas from all parties so that together we will make a success of the Belt and Road Initiative. Our goal is not only to strengthen the physical connectivity of infrastructure, but also to improve institutional connectivity of policies, rules, and standards. BRI projects must be high standard as well as results-oriented, high quality as well as economically viable, beneficial to the world as well as to China. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。
西区第六排，第六排那位女士。
谢谢主持人。王毅部长您好，我是北京电视台记者。那前几天呢，我们都聆听了李克强总理所做的政府工作报告，其中也指出今年是全面贯彻党的十九大精神的开局之年，是改革开放40周年，同时呢，也是决胜全面建成小康社会、实施“十三五”规划承上启下的关键一年。当然，你也曾经多次强调说，服务国家发展始终是中国外交的中心任务。所以呢，我也想更多的去了解一下，今年外交部在这方面还会有哪些举措呢？谢谢。
Beijing TV.Premier Li Keqiang emphasized in his government work report a few days ago that 2018 were kickoff efforts to put the decisions of the 19th Party Congress into action. It is the 40th anniversary of reform and opening up, and it is a crucial year for securing a decisive victory in establishing a moderately prosperous society in all respects, and for implementing the 13th five-year plan. You have often said that facilitating national development is a central goal of China's foreign policy. What will the Ministry of Foreign Affairs do in 2018 to advance this goal?
中国仍然是发展中国家，所以服务国内发展是中国特色大国外交的分内之事。面对新的历史使命和时代要求，外交部将按照中央的统一部署，更加积极有为地做好服务国内发展这篇大文章。我们将适应新形势，按照高质量发展的需要，为走出去、引进来、扩大对外合作来创造更有利条件，为国内发展来营造更良好的国际环境。我们将破解新难题，紧扣社会主要矛盾的变化，打造地方省区市全球推介活动的增强版。我们还将创办反映重大改革举措的专题推介，更有针对性地讲好中国的故事。比如今年，我们将向全球推介雄安新区。扶贫工作，外交部也从不缺位。我们将为打赢扶贫攻坚战来贡献我们的一份力量。我们还将落实新要求，发挥好外交部和驻外机构遍布全球的优势，为一带一路建设铺路架桥，维护好我们国家的海外利益。谢谢。哦，还要强调的是啊，推进新时代中国特色大国外交，我们既要当对外工作的排头兵，也要做服务发展的实干家。
China still being a developing country, facilitating national development is part and parcel of major country diplomacy with Chinese characteristics. Keeping in mind our new mission and what is expected of us, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs will implement the decisions of the central leadership and be more active in facilitating domestic development. We will adapt to the new landscape of high-quality development to create a more favorable environment for external cooperation, including bringing in and going global, and for domestic development as well. We will tackle the new challenges presented by the evolution of the principal contradiction facing Chinese society. To tell China's stories in a more compelling way, we will both upgrade the presentation of Chinese provinces and launch a new series on the major initiatives of reform. For example, later this year, we will host an event to present the Xiong'an new area to the world. In addition, the MFA has been and will continue to be fully engaged in poverty alleviation and do its bit towards winning the nationwide battle against poverty. We will meet the new requirements and leverage our diplomatic and consular assets across the globe to facilitate the Belt and Road Initiative and protect China's overseas interests. Let me emphasize that in the new era, we aim to be not just the pace setter of China's international engagement, but also a solid contributor to domestic development. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。右区第六排中间那位男士，第六排，没错没错，这位。
谢谢主持人，外长您好，我是那个澎湃新闻的记者。我想提给你的问题是，中国同东盟的关系正从成长期迈向成熟期。我们知道，今年是中国东盟建立战略伙伴关系十五周年。请问中方对中国东盟关系有何设想？谢谢。
The paper, China-ASEAN relations have grown in maturity. This year marks the 15th anniversary of the strategic partnership between the two sides. How will China take forward its relationship with ASEAN?
今年是中国东盟建立战略伙伴关系十五周年，具有继往开来的重要意义。 我们看到十五年来中国和东盟的合作、从小到大硕果累累，中国已经连续九年保持东盟第一大贸易伙伴的地位。去年双方的贸易额突破了5000亿美元，人员往来突破了4000万人次，这为中国和东盟各国将近20亿的民众带来了实实在在的利益。中国和东盟的合作已经成为亚太区域合作当中最为成功和最有活力的典范。2018年，我们将继续把东盟放在对外合作议程的首页，打造更高水平的战略伙伴关系，构建更紧密的命运共同体。我们主要要推进三项重点工作：一是规划新蓝图，我们将和东盟一起制定中国东盟战略伙伴关系2030愿景，实现一带一路倡议和东盟发展战略的更好的对接。第二是培育新亮点，在政治安全、经贸、社会人文三大支柱之下，开辟更多的合作领域，增加更多的合作项目，取得更多的合作成果。第三是打造新的高地，我们将进一步培育蓝莓流域经济发展带，构建同东盟东部增长区的合作框架。我们将继续支持东盟共同体的建设，推动区域全面经济伙伴关系的协定能够尽早的达成。谢谢。
As we celebrate the 15th anniversary, 2018 is of particular importance for the future of China-ASEAN strategic partnership. The last 15 years have seen China-ASEAN cooperation go from strength to strength and bear rich fruits. For 9 years running, China has been ASEAN's largest trading partner. Last year, our trade exceeded $500 billion and two-way visits totaled 40 million.all of which brought real benefits to our combined population of nearly 2 billion. Indeed, China-ASEAN cooperation is the most successful and dynamic in the Asia-Pacific region. In the year ahead, we will continue to give highest priority to cooperation with ASEAN, upgrade our strategic partnership, and build a more close-knit community of shared destiny. We have three priorities. First,we will work out a new blueprint of cooperation. The proposed China-ASEAN Strategic Partnership Vision 2030 will lead to a better coordination between the Belt and Road Initiative and ASEAN's development plans. Second, we will foster new highlights of cooperation. Cooperation will be broadened in the political and security, economic and trade, and social and people-to-people areas, with more projects and outcomes in the pipeline. Third,we will forge new platforms of cooperation. Efforts will be made to build a Lantang-Mekong economic development belt, establish a cooperation framework with the East ASEAN growth area, support ASEAN community building, and conclude the regional comprehensive economic partnership as soon as possible. Thank you.
下一个问题，走去第二排这位女士。
Thank you. Goes Straits Times. My question is, things have come in the South China Sea the past year, but there are still concerns over reports of China's continuing militarization of its man-made islands in the South China Sea. I wonder how you would address these concerns. AndAlso, China and ASEAN have agreed on a framework for a code of conduct to manage disputes in the South China Sea and have agreed to begin negotiations on its contents. Are talks likely to be completed this year? And will the new COC be legally binding and enforceable?
海峡时报，去年一年来，南海形势已经平静了很多，但是对于中国在南海岛礁建设的报道 也让人产生对南海军事化的担忧。您对此有何回应？中国和东盟国家在今年年内达成南海行为准则框架及展开实质性谈判的可能性大吗？以及达成的准则是否具有可执行性？
中国维护南海和平稳定的决心不可动摇，诚意始终如一。我们处理南海问题的立足点是对中国人民负责，对历史事实负责，对地区和平负责，对国际法治负责，这一立场坚如磐石，一以贯之。
When it comes to maintaining peace and stability in the South China Sea, China's resolve is as strong as its commitment is deep. China's approach to the South China Sea issue is a responsible one that takes into account the interests of the Chinese people, the facts of history, the imperative of regional peace, and the international rule of law. This position is firm and consistent.
当前南海面临的首先是机遇，正像记者朋友所说，明显的趋稳向好。中国和东盟已经达成了高度的共识，这就是我们愿意通过制定南海行为准则，也就是 COC， 来共同维护目前得来不易的这种安定的局面。就在几天之前，中国和东盟国家就准则的案文进行了首次磋商，取得了积极的进展，而且我们商定年内至少还要举行三次磋商。中国和东盟国家有意愿也有能力，我们以自主的方式来制定出符合地区实际同时各方共同遵守的地区规则。
As you have recognized, the situation in the South China Sea is turning for the better. There is a golden opportunity before China and ASEAN countries. We will agree to develop a code of conduct in the South China Sea to preserve its hard-won tranquility. Last week, our officials held an inaugural round of consultation on the COC text and made encouraging progress. At least three more rounds have been envisaged for the remainder of this year.China and ASEAN countries are willing and able to draft regional rules on our own, rules which will meet our region's imperatives and be adhered to by all.
当然，南海也面临挑战。目前最主要的挑战就是一些外部势力反而对南海风平浪静心有不安，总想挑动是非，唯恐天下不乱。说到军事化，动辄把全副武装的舰船飞机派到南海来炫耀武力，这才是影响南海和平稳定的最大的干扰因素。但是青山遮不住，毕竟东流去。新的一年里边，我们将同东盟国家一起抓住机遇，拓展合作，排除干扰，化解挑战，珍惜双方努力取得的成果，加快准则的磋商进程，同时积极地探索构建起南海沿岸国合作机制，我们共同把南海建设成和平之海、合作之海。谢谢。
There are also challenges in the South China Sea. Some outside forces are not happy with the prevailing calm and try to stir up trouble and muddle the waters. They frequent show of force with fully armed aircraft and naval vessels.In other words, militarization is the most destabilizing factor in our region. It is useful to heed the wisdom of a Chinese verse. Green hills cannot stop the river flowing. To the vast ocean, it keeps advancing. In the year ahead, China will work with ASEAN countries to seize the opportunity, broaden cooperation, prevent interference, and overcome challenges. Cherishing what we have achieved together,China and ASEAN countries will speed up the COC consultation, explore a mechanism of cooperation among the coastal states, and promote peace and cooperation in the South China Sea. Thank you.
好，谢谢。下一个问题，中区第六排那位女士。对，
Good morning, Minister Wang. I'm with CGTN, that's China Global Television Network. Now, in 2018, for the very first time in 12 years, the Forum on China-Africa Cooperation will once again be hosted by China right here in Beijing. Now, what outcome do you expect from that summit? Also, Mr. Minister, the world is evolving, so is China. But one thing that seems to remain unchanged for China, at least, is the importance it attaches to Africa's concerns and interests. And I'm kind of wondering how China stays true to its policy on honesty and amicability towards Africa in the new era. Thank you.
中国国际电视台，今年中国北京将在时隔12年后再次主办中非合作论坛峰会。你对峰会成果有何预期？世界在变，中国在发展，但中国对非洲的诉求和利益的重视似乎一直未变。新时代的中国如何继续坚持对非真实亲诚的理念？
首先我要祝贺CGTN取得了积极的进展。对于中非关系，习近平总书记曾经精辟地指出，中国同非洲国家，我们是患难之交，患难之交不能忘。因此，不管世界上怎样的变化，也不管别人说什么，中非之间的深厚友谊都是牢不可破的。
Congratulations to the CGTN on your success. General Secretary Xi Jinping once made a powerful statement, China and Africa are friends tested by adversity. Such friends must never be forgotten. So be assured, no matter how the world may change or what others might say, the profound friendship between China and Africa will remain unbreakable. And China's promise of sincerity, real results, friendship, and good faith will remain true.
作为非洲国家的好兄弟和好伙伴，我们始终把非洲国家的需要和利益放在心上，想非洲之所想及非洲之所急。非洲当前面临着维护和平安全、促进振兴发展这两大任务，中国 将根据非洲国家的实际需要，加大对非洲热点问题的斡旋，加强同非洲各国在反恐、打击海盗、防灾、减灾这些非传统安全领域的合作，从而不断提高非洲国家的维护自身和平与安全的能力。As
Africa's brother and partner, China will always attach particular importance to the needs and interests of African countries. Africa's concerns are China's concerns. Africa's priorities are China's priorities. Africa faces the twin challenges of maintaining peace and security and of promoting development and revitalization. In response to its needs, China will step up mediation in regional flashpoints, as well as cooperation with African countries on unconventional security threats, such as terrorism, piracy, and natural disaster, and help them build capacity for ensuring their own peace and security.
构建人类命运共同体，非洲是不可或缺的组成部分。我们欢迎非洲的兄弟姐妹继续搭乘中国发展的快车。今年9月份中非合作论坛峰会将在中国举行。 各国领导人时隔12年后会再次齐聚北京，共商新时代的中非合作大计。峰会的主题将聚焦中非共建“一带一路”，共筑中非命运共同体。我们将推动“一带一路”与联合国2030可持续发展议程相对接，与非盟的2063议程相对接。 同时要与非洲各国的发展战略相对接，让中非合作插上“一带一路”的翅膀，飞得更高，飞得更远。谢谢。
Africa is an indispensable partner in our effort to build a global community with a shared future. China welcomes our African brothers and sisters to get on board its fast train of development. The FOCAC summit scheduled for September will bring together Chinese and African leaders again, 12 years after their last gathering in Beijing. They will discuss China-Africa cooperation in the new era and focus on jointly advancing the Belt and Road Initiative and turning China and Africa into a community with a shared future. By aligning the Belt and Road Initiative with the UN's 2030 Agenda, the AU's Agenda 2063, and the development strategies of individual African countries, we will give wings to China-Africa cooperation to help it soar to greater heights. Thank you.
好，谢谢。下一个问题。左区第五排这位男士。不是。
王部长你好，我是日本工作社的陈瑟。今年正值日本中国友好条约缔结40周年，两国外交上相互关系都做出了积极的努力。请问两国领导人是否实现互访？中方怎么评价中国和日本的关系？希望今后的两国关系如何发展？谢谢。
Kyoto News. In this 40th anniversary year of the Japan-China Treaty of Peace and Friendship, both countries have been making active efforts to improve relations. Will we see an exchange of visits between Chinese and Japanese leaders? How does China see the relationship and its future?
希望你继续努力地学好中文。中日关系每次都是记者会的那么话题之一了。但是我们看到这段时间，日本方面采取了更为清晰、更为积极的对华政策，中日关系出现了难得的改善的势头，中方对此表示欢迎。只要日方不犹豫、不折腾、不倒退，客观对待和认同中国的发展，中国愿意与日方相向而行，我们共同推动两国关系回到健康稳定的发展轨道。
I'm sure you will keep working on your Chinese. China-Japan relations seems to be a fixture at my annual press conference.In the recent period, Japan has adopted a clearer and more positive policy towards China, resulting in a precious improvement of relations. China welcomes this. If Japan does not prevaricate, flip-flop, or backpedal, and instead comes to terms with China's development and welcomes it, China will be willing to act in the same spirit and work with Japan to put our relationship back on the track of healthy and steady growth.
今年是中日和平友好条约缔结40周年。40年前的条约以法律的形式确认了正确对待历史、坚持一个中国这些中日关系正常化时所规定的各项政治原则，也明确了两国和平共处、世代友好的大方向。不忘初心，方得始终。40年后。站在承前启后的历史关头，我们希望日方能够政治上讲信用，行动上守规矩，切实维护好两国关系的政治基础，并且把互为合作伙伴、互不构成威胁的政治共识真正落到实处。我相信只要中日关系持续改善，两国的高层往来自然水到渠成。和平友好也将重新成为两国关系的主旋律。谢谢。
40 years ago, China and Japan signed the Treaty of Peace and Friendship. It codified the political principles agreed in negotiating the normalization of Sino-Japanese relations, including handling history correctly and following a One China policy. The treaty also enshrined our joint desire to live in peace and friendship forever. As the saying goes, never forget why you started, and you can accomplish your mission. 40 years on, at another crucial juncture of history, we hope Japan will have political credibility and act accordingly to cement the political foundation of our relations and give effect to the political understanding that China and Japan see each other as partners, not threats. I'm hopeful that with the steady improvement of our relations, high-level visits will naturally come about, and peace and friendship will again be the dominant theme of Sino-Japanese relations. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。
中区第五排这位女士，第五排。谢谢主持人，王院长您好，香港凤凰卫视记者提问：您如何看待美日印澳四国加强合作的印太战略？那在您看来，这是否是对中国的一种围堵？也有人说，这一战略的提出就是为了对冲中国的“一带一路”，中方将如何应对？谢谢。
Phoenix TV. What is China's view of the Indo-Pacific strategy pursued by the US, Japan, India, and Australia? Do you see it as an attempt to contain China or offset China's Belt and Road Initiative? How will China respond to it?
这个世界上各种话题层出不穷，花样翻新，就像太平洋和印度洋上的浪花，一时引人耳目，转瞬归于平静。 确实有些学者和媒体在渲染所谓的印太战略是为了围堵中国，但是我们看到四国官方立即就出面表示，那么他们无意针对任何的国家。我希望他们说的是实话，也希望他们能够言行一致。至于跟“一带一路”什么关系，“一带一路”已经得到了100多个国家和支持。 它就在那个地方。在当今时代，再挑起冷战已经不合时宜，再搞小圈子对抗更没有市场。谢谢。It
seems there is never a shortage of headline-grabbing ideas. These ideas are like the sea foam in the Pacific or Indian Ocean. They may get some attention, but soon will dissipate. Contrary to the claim made by some academics and media outlets that the Indo-Pacific strategy aims to contain China, the four countries' official position is that it targets no one. I hope they mean what they say and their action will match their rhetoric. As to the relationship between the Indo-Pacific strategy and the Belt and Road Initiative, let us not forget that the BRI has received the support of over 100 countries. Nowadays, stoking a new Cold War is out of sync with the times, and inciting bloc confrontation will find no market. Thank you.
好，谢谢。下一个问题。PTI， 右区第二排这位先生。
Oh, thank you. From Press Trust of India, PTI. 2017 has been a very difficult year in India-China relations. The relations were affected by a host of issues, including the standoff at Doklam. You, along and State Councillor Ang Jiechi, visited Delhi and followed by the recent visit of the Indian Foreign Secretary to here for talks with you and other officials. How you see India-China relations shaping up this year? Thank you.
印度报业托拉斯，由于在一系列问题上的分歧和洞朗对峙事件， 2017年是中印关系史上非常困难的一年。今年年初以及去年年底， 杨洁篪国务委员和你相继访印，印度外密访华，中方希望如何塑造今年的中印关系？
中印关系保持着发展的势头，当然也经历了困难和考验，正像你刚才所说的。在此过程当中，中方既坚定维护了自身的正当权益，也积极顾全了中印关系的大局。对于中印关系的发展前景，两国领导人已经达成了重要的战略共识，那就是中印要龙象共舞，而不是龙象争斗。中印一加一不仅等于二，更加等于十一。
Despite some tests and difficulties, the China-India relationship continues to grow. In the process, China has both upheld its legitimate rights and interests and taken care to preserve the relationship. Chinese and Indian leaders have developed a strategic vision for the future of our relations. The Chinese dragon and the Indian elephant must not fight each other, but dance with each other. If China and India are united, 1+1 will equal not only 2, but also 11.
面对当前国际局势的百年变局，我们看到越来越多的有识之士认识到，两个超过十亿人口规模的发展中大国相继走向现代化，最重要的是相互理解、相互支持，最应该避免的是相互猜忌、相互消耗。从这个意义上讲，中印之间迫切需要解决的问题就是互信。建立起政治互信，喜马拉雅山也阻挡不了相互加强友好交往。缺乏互信，一马平川也难使双方走在一起。我要告诉印度朋友的是，中印之间共识远多于分歧，利益远大于摩擦。中方愿意同印度继承弘扬友好传统，同印度人民交朋友、做伙伴，希望双方打开心结，相向而行，用信任代替猜忌，以对话管控分歧，靠合作来开创未来。谢谢。
The international situation is experiencing its biggest change in a century. More and more far-sighted people have come to realize that as the largest two developing countries, each with a population of more than 1 billion, become modernized, China and India must do everything to emphasize with and support each other, and to avoid mutual suspicion and attrition. In this sense, mutual trust is the most precious commodity in China-India relations. With political trust, not even the Himalayas can stop us from friendly exchanges. Without it, not even level land can bring us together. Let me put this to our Indian friends. Our shared understandings far outstrip our differences, and our common interests far outweigh our frictions. China is willing and ready to inherit and take forward our traditional friendship, and be a friend and partner of the Indian people. I hope the two sides will be free from mental inhibitions and meet each other halfway. Let us replace suspicion with trust, manage differences through dialogue, and build a future through cooperation. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。中区第七排那位男士。
谢谢主持人。王毅外长你好，我是来自中国国际广播电台和国际在线的记者。我的问题是关于全面与进步跨太平洋 伙伴关系协定的。据报道，十一国首席代表谈判会议已经就该协定的内容达成了共识，并商定于今天在智利举行签署仪式。该协定呢预计将在最早于2019年正式生效。那么请问您对此怎么看？谢谢。
China Radio International, the chief negotiators of the 11 countries that make up the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership, or CPTPP, have agreed on the final text. It is expected to be signed today in Chile and take effect next year at the earliest. What is your thought on this?
中国并没有参加CPTPP 的协定，但是中国历来是贸易自由化的坚定的支持者，我们也是亚太区域合作和经济一体化的重要的参与方。2014年，正是在中方的推动之下，亚太经合组织领导人非正式会议在北京正式启动了亚太自贸区的进程。而中国正在积极参与的区域全面经济伙伴关系，也就是 RCEP， 是目前正在商谈的覆盖人口最多、成员构成最广的自贸安排。我要说的是，不管是 RCEP 还是你刚才所说的 CPTPP， 只要顺应亚太区域经济一体化的方向，符合透明、开放、包容的原则，有利于维护以 WTO 为核心的全球自由贸易体系，中方都持积极的态度。当然，我们也希望亚太地区各种不同的自贸安排能够彼此沟通协调，形成良性的互动，从各自的角度为抵制贸易保护主义、构建开放型的世界经济来发挥建设性的作用。谢谢。
China is not a party to the CPTPP. However, China has been a strong advocate of trade liberalization and a key player of Asia-Pacific cooperation and economic integration. In 2014, China persuaded other APEC economies to kick off in Beijing the process of establishing a free trade area of the Asia-Pacific. China has also been working actively for the conclusion of the RCEP, or the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, a free trade pact that will cover more populations and involve more diverse economies than any similar initiative. China is positive about any open, transparent, and inclusive arrangement that reinforces regional economic integration and the WTO-centered global free trade system, be it ICEP or CPTPP. We hope to see better communication, coordination, and interaction between the various free trade initiatives in our region so that they may complement one another, help resist trade protectionism, and contribute to a more open global economy. Thank you.
谢谢。下一个问题。中区第三排这位女士。
谢谢。Fagua Falenci, Guanbo Dientai, Radio France. France has a new leading role in Europe. Do you think it could give a new direction to China-EU relationship? Thank you.
法兰西广播公司，法国在欧洲发挥着新的领导作用。您认为法国能引领中国欧盟关系的新方向吗？
2018年是中欧建立全面战略伙伴关系15周年。我们看到年初，马克龙总统就率先对中国进行了国事访问，中法关系展现生机勃发的龙马精神。之后，英国梅首相接踵而来，中英关系要打造黄金时代的增强版。我们期待今年的中欧关系能够高开高走，迈上新台阶。当然，我们也乐见法国能够为此发挥更积极的作用。全球治理合作已经成为中欧双方新的合作增长点，维护全球自由贸易体制也是中欧双方的共同责任。同时啊，商签中欧投资保护协定有必要提速前进。中欧之间当然也存在一些分歧，但是我们双方都意识到应该多一些换位思考，多一些开放包容，多一些相互理解。就中方而言，我们始终重视欧洲，支持欧洲的一体化，看好欧洲的发展前景。我们愿意同欧洲合作，为当今充满不确定性的时代来注入更多的稳定性和正能量。谢谢。
This year will mark the 15th anniversary of the China-EU Comprehensive Strategic Partnership. The year started with President Macron
paying a state visit to China, and Sino-French relations in excellent shape. Then the visit of Prime Minister May kicked off efforts by China and the UK to upgrade their golden era of relations. We hope at the end of the year, China-EU relations will be as strong as we have started it. We hope France will make a substantial contribution to the furtherance of China-EU cooperation. Global governance has emerged as a new dimension of such cooperation. China and the EU have a shared responsibility to safeguard the global free trade system. And negotiation needs to be speeded up to conclude a China-EU investment agreement. There are also some disagreements between China and the EU, but both sides have realized the need to put oneself in the other's shoes and to be more open, tolerant, and understanding of one another. China has always appreciated the importance of Europe. We support European integration and have confidence in Europe's future. Given all the uncertainty around us, China is ready to partner with Europe to provide more stability and make the world a better place. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。右区第七排，第七排那位男士。
谢谢主持人，我是中国新闻社中国新闻网记者。我们注意到近两年中国国内民众对于领事保护工作异常关注，不管是通过《红海计划》《战狼》这样的影视剧作品，还是通过一次次成功的撤侨的事件，大家的民族自豪感都在显著的提升。但与此同时，也有一种声音认为，我们应该理性地看待领事保护工作，并且慎重使用领保资源。请问王毅外长，您对此如何看待？谢谢。
China News Service. Chinese people are following closely the consular assistance and protection they're getting while abroad. They also expect more to be done. At the same time, there are appeals for a more rational understanding of consular service and a better use of it. What is your view?
领保是每年的必答题了，因为它关系到人民群众的利益，关系到千家万户的幸福。作为外交部，做好领保工作是我们义不容辞的责任。2017年，中国内地居民出境达到了1.3亿人次。面对越来越繁重的领保任务，我们坚持以人民为中心，持续地打造有法律支撑、机制建设、风险评估、安全预警、预防宣传和应急处置这六大支柱来构成的海外中国平安体系。去年一年，外交部总共处理了7万多起领保案件，包括从火山喷发的印尼巴厘岛协助游客安全回国，从遭遇飓风灾害的多米尼克把侨胞安全转移到平安的地区，12308领保热线接听了17万通来电，比2016年增加了10万通。当然，预防啊是最好的保护。外交部去年我们共发布了各类海外安全提醒1000多条，把大量的风险化解在我们公民踏出国门之前。随着国家的发展和中外交流的增加，我们看到中国公民的素质不断提高，依法维权的意识不断增强，维护国家形象的自觉也在不断的提升，这为外交部做好领保工作提供了更有力的支持和帮助。
Consular assistance and protection seems to have become a must-have question at my annual press conference. Indeed, it potentially concerns the interests and well-being of every Chinese and their family. Making a good job of it is the unshirkable responsibility of the Foreign Service. Last year, as many as 130 million mainlanders traveled overseas. Given the growing magnitude of their consular needs, we adopted a people-centered approach and built a system for ensuring their safety, which consists of 6 pillars, namely legal provisions, institution building, risk assessment, early warning, awareness raising, and emergency response. In 2017 alone, the MFA handled more than 70,000 cases of consular assistance and protection, including evacuating Chinese tourists stranded by the erupting volcano on Bali, Indonesia, and getting our nationals to safety from hurricane-ravaged Dominica. The 12308 consular hotline handled 170,000 calls, 100,000 more than in 2016. Prevention is the best protection. Last year, the MFA issued more than 1,000 travel advisories, which significantly reduced our citizens' risk exposure even before they traveled abroad. As China develops and interacts more with the world, the social etiquette and civility of its citizens are being enhanced. Nowadays, they're more inclined to protect China's reputation as well as their own rights. This new awareness has made our job easier.
2018年，林保工作将在打造海外平安体系的道路上继续前行。我现在这里宣布三个利民的好消息。第一是外交部正在推进领事保护与协助的立法工作，将在两会之后向社会公开征求意见，欢迎大家踊跃参与，提出宝贵的意见。第二呢，是我们将在已经开通的中国领事服务网12308微信版、领事之声微博这些平台的基础上，很快推出12308的手机 APP， 这样可以为大家提供更便捷的贴身的服务。第三，是从明天开始，中国所有驻外使领馆将统一大幅下调中国公民办理领事认证的费用，降幅达到2/3。初步估算，每年将为中国公民和企业节约上千万元的人民币。谢谢。
In 2018, we will further improve the system for ensuring the safety of Chinese nationals abroad. Here I have three pieces of good news for you. First, the MFA is working on draft legislation on consular protection and assistance. Public consultation will begin after the close of the NPC and CPPCC sessions. We welcome your input and suggestions. Second, in addition to a dedicated website, the WeChat version of 12308, and the China Consular Affairs account on Weibo, we will soon launch the 12308 smartphone app to make consular services more accessible to the people. Third, as of tomorrow, our diplomatic and consular missions around the world will slash consular legalization fees by as much as 2/3. The fee reduction is expected to save Chinese citizens and businesses more than 10 million yuan every year. Thank you.
下一个问题，左区第六排，塔斯社记者。
啊，王毅外长您好，我是同时塔斯社的记者。作为上海合作组织扩员后的首任轮值主席国，中方希望通过今年主办上海合作组织青岛分会实现什么目标？你今天提到上合组织这个经验，多说一遍。好，谢谢。
TAS, assuming the presidency right after the Shanghai Cooperation Organization admitted new members, what does China hope to accomplish at the Qingdao Summit?
上合组织是在中国诞生的，青岛峰会呢，将是扩员之后的首次峰会。我们欢迎上合组织再次在中国开会，也期待上合组织啊从青岛再出发。我们愿意各成员方共同努力，推动峰会实现三大目标：一是增强凝聚力，以互信互利、平等协商为核心的上海精神，是上合组织创立时的初心所在。我们将与各成员一道，高举上海精神这一旗帜， 增进成员之间的互信与团结，构建更加紧密的上合民营共同体。二是提高行动力，务实高效，互利共赢的合作，这是上合组织发展的动力源泉。我们将和各成员一道制定上合组织成员国长期睦邻友好条约未来五年的实施纲要，还将签署和批准一系列涉及到安全、经贸、环保和人文等领域的决议与合作文件，助力成员国参与一带一路建设，实现上合组织的全方位的发展。三是扩大影响力，维护本地区乃至世界的和平稳定，这是上合组织义不容辞的国际责任。我们将和各成员一道积极回应国际社会的期待，就重大的国际和地区问题发出更响亮的上合声音，为区域合作和全球经济治理发挥更积极的上合作用。总之啊，青岛峰会将成为上合组织发展进程中一座新的里程碑，将开启这一新型区域组织的新时代。谢谢。
The Shanghai Cooperation Organization was born in China, and the Qingdao Summit will be the first one after the SCO admitted new members. We welcome the SCO back to China and expect it to embark on a new journey in Qingdao. China looks forward to working with other members to achieve three goals at the summit. First, making the SCO more cohesive. The Shanghai spirit of mutual trust, mutual benefit, and equal-footed consultation encapsulates the founding principle of our organization. We will work with other members to uphold this spirit, enhance trust and solidarity, and build a more close-knit SCO community of shared future. Second, making the SCO more effective. The SCO is driven by results-oriented, efficient, and mutually beneficial cooperation. China will work with other members to promote its all-round development, including developing a five-year outline for the implementation of the Treaty on Long-Term Good Neighborliness, Friendship and Cooperation, concluding or ratifying a number of resolutions or documents concerning security, economic, environmental, and cultural cooperation, and advancing Belt and Road projects in SCO member states. Third, by making the SCO more influential, our organization has a bounden duty to maintain peace and stability in our region and beyond. China will work with other members to help the SCO meet international expectations, take a clearer stand on major international and regional issues, and play a more active role in regional cooperation and global economic governance. To sum up, we will make the Qingdao Summit a new milestone in the history of the SCO and launch this new type of regional organization into a new era. Thank you.
谢谢，请继续提问。右区第二排，这位女士。
谢谢主持人，中评社中评网记者提问。外长您好，我们知道这个继冈比亚和顺普之后，这个巴拿马也在去年选择了同台湾断交与中国大陆建交，这样那想请问一下外长，您觉得这未来会是一个趋势吗？以及说台湾舆论所担心的这个雪崩式的断交潮是否会出现呢？谢谢。
China Review News. Following the example of the GambiaAnd Sao Tome and Principe, Panama decided last year to switch diplomatic relations from Taipei to Beijing. Do you think more countries will follow suit? Will Taiwan face an avalanche of ruptured diplomatic ties, as its media have feared?
世界上只有一个中国，台湾是中国不可分割的一部分。这已经是国际社会多年来形成的共识。坚持一个中国原则，不同台湾进行官方往来，也已经成为各国遵循的国际准则之一。同唯一合法代表中国的中华人民共和国政府建立外交关系，开展正常的 合作，显然是顺应时代潮流的正确的选择，也完全符合这些国家和人民的自身和长远利益，当然是大势所趋，而且势不可挡。
There is only one China in the world, and Taiwan is an inseparable part of China. This has been the consensus of the international community for decades. Adhering to the One China principle and not having official ties with Taiwan has become a generally observed norm in international relations. It is obviously a correct choice in line with the tide of history to establish diplomatic relations and carry out regular cooperation with the government of the People's Republic of China, the sole legal representative of the whole of China. Such a choice would best serve the immediate and long-term interests of the countries and the peoples in question. Of course, this is the overriding trend and an unstoppable one.
我还要说的是，承认九二共识，认同两岸同属一中，这是推进两岸关系向前发展的关键所在。解铃还需系铃人，台湾当局应该尽快回到九二共识的正确轨道上来，这样两岸关系才能重新开辟和平发展的光明前景。谢谢。
The key to unlocking the cross-straits stalemate lies in recognizing the 1992 consensus and acknowledging that the two sides of the Taiwan Straits belong to one and the same China. The party that has locked the door must unlock it. The Taiwan authorities should return to the 1992 consensus as soon as possible. This correct move will create a bright future for the peaceful development of cross-straits relations. Thank you.
谢谢。由于时间关系，再提最后两个问题。
第四中区第四排这位先生，这位记者先生，对。
Thank you, Foreign Minister, for FA from Spain. In the last China CELAC meeting in Santiago, which you attended, after that meeting, the United States warned Latin American countries about the growing Chinese influence in the region. Do you feel there is a growing rivalry between China and the United States for influence in Latin America and the Caribbean? Thank you. 谢谢。
埃菲社记者，王外长，您出席了中国拉共体论坛第二届部长级会议。在会后，美方呼吁拉美国家要警惕中国在该地区的影响。美中是否在加大争夺在拉美和加勒比海地区的影响？您怎么看？
中拉合作，这是发展中国家之间的相互帮助和相互支持。不针对和取代谁，也无意去动谁的奶酪。中拉合作之所以发展这么快，是因为它符合拉美国家的客观的需求，也改善了拉美国家的民生，更提高了拉美国家的自主发展能力。过去五年，习近平主席三次踏上拉美大陆，他的足迹遍及十个拉美国家，中拉合作不断地拓展深化体制升级。中国目前已经是很多拉美国家的主要贸易伙伴，中国企业为拉美累计创造了180多万个就业的岗位。中国古人云，治河者不以山海为源，这句话恰如其分地反映了当前的中拉关系的现状。宽广的太平洋正在把中拉双方连接在一起，使我们成为跨越万水千山的合作的伙伴。谢谢。
China and Latin American and the Caribbean countries are helping and supporting each other as fellow developing countries. Our cooperation does not target or seek to replace anyone, and China.Is not going to move anyone's cheese, so to speak. China's cooperation with the region has grown rapidly because it suits its needs, improves lives there, and boosts its capacity for self-driven growth. During the last 5 years, President Xi has visited Latin America and the Caribbean 3 times, taking in 10 countries. Our cooperation has deepened, expanded, and moved up the value chain. China has become a key trading partner for many in the hemisphere. Chinese businesses and investors have created more than 1.8 million local jobs. The Chinese saying, nothing, not even mountains or oceans, can separate those with a shared goal, aptly describes the state of our relations with Latin America and the Caribbean. The vast Pacific Ocean binds us together, making us partners in cooperation, whatever may stand between us. Thank you.
谢谢。 最后一个问题。 中区第四排中间那位男士。
谢谢主持人，外长好，新华社记者提问。 我的问题是， 习总书记在十九大报告中指出啊， 要全面推进中国特色的大国外交，那我想问， 展望今后一个时期， 您如何展望中国的大国外交？谢谢。
Xinhua News Agency. In his report to the 19th Party Congress, General Secretary Xi called for making all-round efforts in the pursuit of major country diplomacy with Chinese characteristics. How do you envisage such diplomacy going forward?
Xi Jinping 总书记在十九大报告当中强调，中国共产党不仅要为中国人民谋幸福，也要为人类进步事业而奋斗。中国共产党 始终把为人类做出新的更大贡献作为自己的使命。秉持这样的信念和担当，我们将进一步拓展广阔的格局。中国将在为自身发展营造更好外部环境的同时，放眼全球，胸怀世界，与各国携手构建人类命运共同体，把建设相互尊重、 公平正义、合作共赢的新型国际关系和持久和平、普遍安全、共同繁荣、开放包容、清洁美丽的世界作为中国外交的总体方向和目标。我们将进一步展现博大的情怀。无论发展到什么程度，中国都会坚持大小国家一律平等，坚持尊重不同文明体制， 坚持正确一体观，反对以大欺小，反对恃强凌弱，为弱小国家主持公道，帮助欠发达国家实现发展。我们将进一步发挥积极的作用。中国将顺应国际社会越来越多的期待，秉持共商共建共享的全球治理观，更加积极地参与全球治理体系的改革和建设， 更加建设性地参与地区和国际热点问题的政治解决，更加有效地与各方携手应对各种全球性的挑战。In
his report to the 19th Party Congress, General Secretary Xi Jinping emphasized that China will strive for both the well-being of the Chinese people and human progress. To make new and greater contributions for humanity is the abiding mission of the Communist Party of China. A committed and responsible China will adopt a more visionary foreign policy. While securing an enabling environment for its own development, China will be concerned with the welfare of humanity and partner with other countries to build a global community of shared future. Our overall objective is to forge a new type of international relations that features mutual respect, fairness, justice, and win-win cooperation, and to build an open, inclusive, clean, and beautiful world that enjoys lasting peace, universal security, and common prosperity. We will have a broader mind. No matter what stage of development it reaches, China will stand for the equality of all countries, large or small, and will respect different civilizations and systems. China will put the greater good before its self-interest, and oppose the practice of the big and strong bullying the small and weak. China will stand up for small and weak countries and help less developed countries achieve better growth. And we will play a more active role. China will strive to meet international expectations and approach global governance on the basis of extensive consultation, joint contribution, and shared benefits. China will be more active in helping to reform and improve the global governance system, find more constructive ways to settle regional and international issues by political means, and forge more effective partnerships to address various global challenges.
大道之行, 天下为公, 我们将坚定不移维护国家主权和民族尊严, 坚定不移, 站在国际正义和人类进步一边, 坚定不移, 做世界和平的建设者, 全球发展的贡献者, 国际秩序的维护者, 谢谢大家。
An ancient Chinese classic teaches that when justice prevails, the world will be one community. We are determined to uphold our country's sovereignty and dignity. We are determined to be on the side of international justice and human progress. We are determined to build world peace, contribute to global prosperity, and uphold the international order. I thank you all.
谢谢。
我们当然要求美国要严格恪守他做出的承诺，遵守一个中国的原则，那么坚持中美三个联合公报。好，不要喊呗。好吧，到了12点了。
I'm afraid our time is up.
谢谢，本场记者会到此结束。
谢谢，
谢谢外长，谢谢大家。
Thank you all for coming.